Hello, viewers. I'll say it again. Hello, viewers, because I don't know why, but Frapp seems to, like, cut off whatever I say at the start sometimes, so gotta be careful, you know, because this is the start of Kotomi's path. Also, I'd like to get off subject for a bit here. Happy New Year and all that old bollocks. I think my video that I made for the New Year thing was much better than just saying that, of course. Because, actually, while I'm recording this, it's actually the 29th, and I recorded the Happy New Year video thing even before then. But anyway, I'm gonna get off subject here. Any of you played Project Zero 3, aka Fatal Frame 3, to you viewers? If any of you have, did any of you, like, completely rage when you got to the final boss, or those annoying shrine maidens that hide in the walls and dive down at you? Those shrine maiden girls, worst ghosts I have ever faced in a Project Zero game. By far. That's even worse than the final boss. I was facing the final boss, and I kept losing, because it's like, she takes to this black and white thing, like, sometimes, and all she has to do is touch you, and you die. I lost my stone mirror, and then she'd immediately kill me again. Every time, I get like 2 or 3 shots in on her, and then she'll eventually kill me. Quite fast, I might add. So, getting to the point now. So, when I messed up the most, all I had was, the highest kind of film I had was Type 61, because K, for some reason, had a Type 0 film and Type 91 and all that, so I couldn't use it. So I accidentally forgot to equip the 61, and the first shot I got in was with Type 14 film. That's pretty pathetic. And after that, she kept spamming that attack where she just dives into the air and you can't get at her, but she can get at you. And she kept sending me back and forth to the black and white thing. I lost my stone mirror, and she kept sending me back. I barely got any shots in. Like, she'd send me back to the black and white world like 3 to 4 times before I even get a chance to get a shot in. And when I do, I usually screwed up. So anyway, I was somehow miraculously able to avoid all of those shots. It was insane. I avoided every one of her attempts at trying to one-shot me. I don't know how the hell it happened, because she did it at least over 10 times before I even beat her. I can't believe I even managed to defeat her. I mean, that was like the most fail one, where I screwed up the most, and yet I came out on top. But anyway, that has nothing to do with Clannad. It's probably annoyed you for me talking about it. If I want to talk about something, I guess I should talk over it in, say, like, a game like Echo or something, you know, when I'm actually doing something the whole time, instead of, like, having to read and all that. Anyway, a world, surface of white. I can see that. Snow. Well, it has yet to snow here. Yes, snow. Continuing to fall down even now, it covers my body in white. Ah. What am I doing in such a world? Since when have I been alone in this place? Also, what do you think of the intro? Okay, I'll shut up and get on with it. Buried in snow was my hand. That hand was holding something. I pull it up. A hand of pure white. It was a girl's hand. Ah, that's right. I was not alone. I brushed off the snow covering her face. Her figure, which slept quietly, surfaced. That's right. We were always together, in this world, in this sad, lonely world. Proceeding. I hate this town. Oh, get over it, Tamoya! Because it's a place stained with memories I want to forget. As usual. Every day, going to school, chatting with friends, then going to a home I don't like. Nothing new ever happens. Bull! Freaking shit! I wonder if anything will ever change like this. You're damn right it will. I wonder if my life will ever be any different. You're damn right it will! The untouched and natural growth of this town. The weaving around hills to get to school. I wonder how convenient it would be be to attend school if you could wipe off all these hills. If I could take a straight path, it would probably cut down my walking time by 20 minutes. One day, 20 minutes. So then, how much time will I save in a year? I do the math as I walk. I don't know. Nor do I particularly care. I mean, what's there to be thinking about there? There aren't any other students from my school around. Normally, since this is the main path to school, it should be bristling with them. It's not like today is a holiday or anything. Which means now it isn't the time for people to be arriving at school. I ignore this laid-back image though and continue walking at the same speed. 200 meters until I reach the school gates. I stand for a bit. Taking a breath, I look up at the sky. Also, I haven't really been recording all that much lately because of Project Zero 3. It's insane. It's an addictive game. I've already beat it now, but I want to, like, unlock everything. I know I'm going off subject again, but no, I'm probably still going to be recording, like, on a daily basis when I start uploading, but still, it's very distracting from it. Like, this is very distracting from the plot. The school gates are just ahead. Who decided to put the gates all the way up there? And for the last, well, not the last time, because we're going to say it again eventually. Wait, what was I going to say again? Oh, forget it. This long road is stretching out like a nightmare. It's a different breath of mine, smaller and more gentle. I look beside me. There is a girl standing as still as I am. Well, she actually has, like, quite a, importance to the plot in Kotomi's path. So we'll be seeing more of Nagisa for a change, you know. I can tell that she's a third-year student by the color of her badge. But she isn't someone I know. Her short hair is fluttering in the wind, just above her shoulders. She looks like she's about to cry. I don't usually judge people by appearance, but she looks very honest. She looks like the kind of girl who would be too timid to enter the classroom alone. She closes her eyes and nods repeatedly for a few moments, as if she had something to tell herself. Then she opens her eyes. She looks at the tall school gate with a firm eye.
この学校は好きですか?
Eh? No, she probably wasn't speaking to me. She was probably talking to someone inside her heart. Cheesy. How would this man, or perhaps a woman, answer her?
私はとってもとっても好きです。でも、何もかも変わらずにはいられないです。楽しいこととか、嬉しいこととか、全部変わらずにはいられないです。
With great difficulty, she continues to speak.
それでも、この場所が好きでいられますか?私は…
Just have to find it, right?
うん?
Surprised, she looks at me, as if she believed that she was alone until now. Just have to find the next fun or happy thing, right? It's wrong to think that there's only one thing like that. That's right. There were times when we were innocent and naive. Oh, but those days are long gone. It's a phase everyone goes through. Come on, let's go. I still have no idea what that says. Or that. I should really study some Japanese, you know, but I don't know how to go about doing so. It's the
final.
Shut up. The teacher calls out the name of a single student.
相変わらずいないのか?
I glance at Tsunohara's seat beside me. His attendance is even worse than mine. We are the only two students in this class known as delinquents. I guess that's why we get along. Also, he's the only person I can really talk to freely, that's how we are. The lesson has started. I spent my time looking out the window, ignoring everything the teacher's saying.
Why do I keep putting on weird accents every now and then? I don't know. The class has ended and school is over. That Sonohara didn't show up at all. In the end, the only person I talked to today was the girl with from this morning. Today is no different from any other day. I'm not part of any club, so I pick up my empty bag and slip out of the classroom while the rest of the students are chatting away. Even if I go home, there won't be anyone there right now. I don't have a mother to begin with. She died in a car accident when I was young. I don't even remember her face. My father, who was left behind, sank into depression, probably affected by the shock of her death. He'd go out, get drunk, and waste his time gambling. My entire childhood was wasted from always fighting with him. But after a certain incident, our relationship changed. He became violent and injured me. From that day forward, my father kept his thoughts to himself. Then instead of calling me in the normal way, he started calling me Tomoya-kun, with a kun at the end, as though I were a stranger. Without a doubt, that made us feel unrelated. Just like a closed shell. Just like a point in time that separates the present from the past. It would have been better if he had just completely ignored me. If he cared enough to cause me pain, there would still be hope. But now, if he sees me come home, he smiles as if seeing an old friend, and begins to chat. It would cause me so much pain that I couldn't take it anymore. I would rush out of the house. And so, in order to avoid him, I have lived my life not returning home until late at night, after he was asleep. I go to sleep at dawn and wake up around noon. Ever since I entered high school, I've always been late. This has been going on for 3 years. Today, as always, I changed my clothes and left before my father got up. Home, whatever. That's what I've become used to.
Damn, we only take one step outside and it's already freaking dark.
I roam around the town at night, and I end up going to the same place at the end of the day. Hell. No, I buy my dinner at the convenience store. And with it in hand, I head down the school slope towards the student dormitory. The student actively promotes club activities, so there are a lot of students here. They spend their 3 years here away from their parents. They are very different from a person who lives out his school life, no dreams like me.
It's none of my business, but in this place the rare Sonohara lives here. Even Sonohara, the creature known as Sonohara, got into the school for sports, as he was once a part of the soccer team. But in his first year, he got into a big fight with students from another school and got suspended. He was removed from being a regular player. And then after his freshman year, he lost his place on the team. There was nothing he could do but leave them. As he couldn't really afford to move anywhere else, he ended up remaining in his dorm, which is reserved for students of sports clubs. If that is so, why is he still there?
何度言えばわかるんだよ!
でも、すげえ小さい音だったっての!
Sonohara is there. He's in front of another room talking with a student with a huge body.
すげえ小さい音でも、壁が薄いから響くんだよ! ヘッドホンで聞けよ!
んな高級なもんねえって…
じゃあ、聞くな!
いや… でも、あれ聞かないと調子出ないんだよね。 それに、結構活かす音楽だと思うんだよね。 今度、歌詞とかちゃんと聞いてみてよ。 活かしてるから。
What lyrics?
活かしてるも何もね! こっちは、ムカついてんだよ! 次聞こえてきたら、叩き出すぞ!
Sonohara's head slumps down before the closed door.
So, rugby bume.
He mumbles to himself. He's not gonna hear you like that.
Damn that rugby player!
I
I correct him with a yell, and he stands beside me. Sunahara grabs me by the head and drags me into his room. In the hallway, a large voice bellows, "Who the hell was that?"
Boku o koro suki ka?
You're the one who said that, aren't you?
Ano sa, Okazaki. Tada de sae koko no tokoro, renchuu to no kankei ga odayaka ja nakunatte run da kara sa.
These days, were you like never on good terms with him to begin with? So let's go all out right now.
Ato 1 nen nokotteru yo!
You really don't have any guts, do you?
Ano ne, boku datte 1-1 nara hiku koto wa nai sa. Tatoe, aite ga rugby bu da toshite mo ne. Kedo, mawari wa zenbu rugby bu no heya. Konna basho de koto o okoshita hi niya, bu ga waru sugiru yo. Demo ma, sotsugyo magiwa ni nattara hade ni yaru no mo ii ne. Son toki wa Okazaki, boku no senaka wa omae ni makaseru ze.
Lucky I'll stab you well.
Kuru na yo, ike yo!
But I'm on the rugby team side, see?
It's kara da yo!
Well, just that time.
Hai? Nande yo? Tomo ni sugoshite kita bokura no 2 nenkan wa ittai nani yo?
The wall shakes. An angry shout saying, "Be quiet!" follows after that. I'll kick back.
Yamete kure!
You're way too jumpy.
Omae na, boku no tachiba ni tatte miro yo.
He's crying.
Kanomu kara, koko de wa otonashiku shitete kure.
Okay, that miserable look is overpowering me. I've like gone through this kind of thing so many times now that I'm actually getting used to like the lines before they even pop up on screen. I began eating from my lunchbox, sitting between the katatsu and the wall of this small room. Tea, please.
Deneyo!
That's why I said please, right?
Adama sageyo ga deneyo! Omae, koko ga shokudou ka nanka to kanchigai shite nai?
This is your room, I know. And you are my slave.
Zenzen wakatte nai ssu ne.
Come on, man, I forgot to buy it.
Jibun de iku という発想は浮かばないのかよ?
But you said helping me is your only purpose in life ever since I saved you, right?
そんな裏設定は隠されていません!
Didn't you say it like this after I saved you? The man called Sunahara died at that moment. The person in here right now is just someone who will serve you tea. So, tea.
壮大な嘘つかな!
And then I'll settle for our last cup of tea.
最初も最後もねえよ!
Oh god, this is touching. If you listen to this, you'll definitely want to get tea for me. Losing the battle against a fatal injury, there was no hope left of saving you. And in that condition, you were committed to bringing me tea. For I was thirsty. From there, you squeezed out every last ounce of your strength as you crawled up to me to pour some tea. And then, Master Okazaki, here is some tea. And this will be your last tea. You were smiling when you died.
僕、むちゃくちゃ本望そうっすね。
That was what you hoped for, after all. And then, while crying, I drank that last cup of tea. Touching, isn't it? So tea.
Dine ってな!
After that, I spent the rest of the day reading magazines. What a boring lifestyle, but more interesting than mine. Well, actually, no, it is similar to mine, only mine would involve just playing video games. Anyway, I'll see you next time.